another great British songbook, but before we pop it back on the shelf for another year, there's just enough time to read one more page.
No, hang on, wait. This is my absolute favourite bit. I've left it open on that page.
I'll read it. Generally favoured by women and popularised throughout the 1990s, this undergarment is sometimes also referred to as a G-string.
And look, hang on, wait. If you turn over, there's a picture that I really like as well.
This is the great British thong book. Besides, I never said you could borrow it.
Yeah, but I might just hang on to it until next weekend.
I need it because
I need it. I'm alone. I'm alone.
Guys.
Now it's time to make some noise. The man we'd love to see in a thong. It's Dermot O'Leary.
Favourite songs of all time.
All time, yeah.
Such a great
song. Have you ever worn a thong?
Living la vida loca. I must have done somewhere. I've been in TV for about 15 years.
Some of your life.
Yes, come on.
There must have been like a moment where there was a thong.
Yeah.
Kind of been that memorable though.
No.
Maybe we should stop talking about thongs and talk about, was Sam Callahan the right person to go home?
Oh. Really good transition.
Sorry.
That's a good change.
It's Great British Songbook Week on the X Factor this week, so I've come to the house to give the contestants a great British quiz. Who's Prime Minister?
David Cameron.
Absolutely right. Name all four members of the Beatles.
Elton John.
Okay, no.
Freddie Mercury.
George Harrison.
John Lennon.
Yeah.
Paul McCartney.
Yeah.
Bloke off Thomas Tank Engine.
I'll accept that as an answer. What is the full name of the Queen?
That's her name, the Queen.
Elizabeth III.
What is the national flower of Scotland?
Just wanted to say broccoli.
Broccoli. Name three Shakespeare plays.
Hansel and Gretel. Is that
no.
Thor.
What's this?
Oh, spring onions.
It's a leek.
Same thing.
What's the national anthem called?
The national anthem. Oh no, that's wrong.
It's a good thing they can sing because they know nothing. To the Xtra Factor. In a moment, we'll be chatting to Sam Bailey, the girls, and our celebrity panel.
But first, it's time to talk about next week's theme. Hey guys, it's the X Factor's 10th birthday.
Happy birthday. Oh. I absolutely love 10th birthdays. And Caroline, we've actually got loads of birthday cards. Should we read some out?
Let's do it.
Lush. Okay, first up, this one's from Daisy. She's from Milton Keynes and she's 7. Ah. And as you can see, her mum's helped her stick a picture of herself onto Tesco Mary's deli counter. And it says, Happy Birthday, X Factor. Isn't that sweet?
Very sweet. Next up, we've got Bob. He's only 5 years old. Now, Bob's done a lovely card of
so lovely.
Alexander Berg doing a duet with a dinosaur. And he says,
fun.
Congratulations on the continued success of the show. It's nice. It really is a winning format that stood the test of time with sustained popularity across all the key demographics. So they're adorable at that age.
So cute. And I've got one more, which is this. And I mean, it doesn't really look like a card. It actually just says P45 for M. Richardson, and it's from S. Cal, and they haven't even drawn a picture on it or anything.
It's weird, that must have got mixed up with the, one of the mistakes.
Am I getting a raise? Is that...
Probably, I don't know. It's just really odd. Time to crack on, everyone, and make some noise to Sam Bailey and the girls! First, it's time for some serious A-list action. Here's what happened when Miley Cyrus visited Matt in his what? No,
I need to talk about this.
No, we don't.
No, I need to.
Over to you, Matt, in his dressing room.
Oh, no.
She's not coming.
What? Why? Why?
Embarrassing. Oh. Awkward.
Yeah, she was meant to turn up, but she was genuinely ill.
Yeah, we all use that excuse.
No. She was afraid she was going
to
fall in love with me.
We're going to have to really up the mood now, because that's a bit of a disappointment. How about...
A dip in the tub!
No one knows that.
Splish, splash, I was taking a bath.
No, you're fine. Can I have a chat?
Tell me what's been going on in the household. I know
everything. Well, I tidied my room for the first time yesterday.
For the first time? You've been living here 6 weeks, and you tidied your room once. Now to Mary. There's been a lot of speculation, like we've talked about on our show. But just me and you here now, what's happened between you and Sam Callahan? And? What's your favourite thing about Sam?
He's, like, so unbelievably not funny. It's hilarious. Because he always makes these jokes, and, like, I miss them all the time, and he's, like, waiting for me to laugh.
Sorry. So what's been happening? Come on, you've got to say.
You're not getting anything else out of me.
Bye, man.
Fine.
Enjoy your bath.
See you later.